Hi, in this video, I will show you how you can use the SAS export package to build a web application that is displaying data from SAS Viya, but without querying the CAS server. I will open up a report in SAS Visual Analytics. In that report, we will have a few key values and graphs. I will use the first screen where we see here the key values and the filters that will filter the data on the report. My objective will be to simulate a portal page where you see some KPIs at the top, but I still want to see the data being filtered by year. So what I will do is export the report package. And in the report package, I will select the objects that I want to display. So in this case, I want to filter by ship year, and I want to display the cost key value for the total warranty, the total labor cost key value, and the total claim count key value. I don't want to persist the content on the SAS content, but I will download it to my machine. And we will see what can be done after that using the package. So what is happening behind the scene? The package is created for you and it is downloaded on your machine. Then what I will do is open up the package and extract it. As you see, the package is having an extension SAS report package.zip file, and expanding it displays more information. In the information, we have the index.html, some CSS file, some metadata, and the report XML, and the report package itself. I will open that within the Visual Studio Code in order to edit and to see the content. I will open the folder on the download demo warranty. There we go. So this is the content of the file that we have seen. By default, when you export, you get an index.html, which can be used to display the information in your own web page. I have into Visual Studio Code a run live server, and this will start up a HTTP server for me. You will see that the objects are rendered. You see here that we have the filters, but we have also the other objects in key values. The layout is not really nice. So what I want to do is adapt the layout within Visual Studio Code. For that, I will download Bootstrap from the official Bootstrap website. I only need the CSS, no need for JavaScript in this case. I will paste it in my code. And from there, I will adapt the web page. I don't need to use the default CSS, and I will create some divs to provide a better layout for my components. I will use the container. Then within the container, I will define some rows, and the filter will be displayed as a row. You see, the good point is that when exporting, the index.html contains the information about the name of the object, which makes it really easy to follow up with the development and to make the link with the report that was available. I will create another row, and within that row, I will define some columns because I want to display the objects. So the KPIs in a single row, but multiple columns. And the last one, div class equal col, and move it down here. Then what I will do is just save. And when the report is saved, I can navigate back to my report, which will, after a refresh, display the objects. As you can see, I still have the possibility to filter the data and to display the information by object. Not all objects are interactive. So that means that if you have other objects in your report, you might have to think about exporting them and in order to use them. Luckily, we are providing a list of objects with the information about their level of support. So you have different levels of support, and for each object, you can find the information in the documentation about the functionality that is available for each object in your VA report. The biggest difference between the report object and in the SAS report package when exported and using the SAS VA SDK, you are really cutting the link with the SAS Viya environment. By that, I mean that in your report, in the page that we have seen in the index.html that we have updated, we are not querying the CAS server anymore. The data is embedded within the report package. So that means that you can deploy it on a web server of your web server of choice, on any cloud provider, for example. And there will be no need to have the SAS environment, the SAS Viya environment running in the background. It can be a standalone application and it can provide the information. We have done it in the interface using VA, but you can also use the client application. By that, I mean the SAS Viya CLI, where you can export the report. And you have the instruction to export the report using the command lines. This means that you can use it in a more DevOps process where you will export the report objects and then save them in a Git repository, for example, and deploy them in your application. This can be done daily, weekly, or monthly, or even yearly. So it's up to you to decide how often you want to refresh your components. The big interest is also that you don't need to configure your SAS Viya environment for specific usage. So in the sense that you don't need to configure the CSRF or the CORS security, it's available in your web server. So it's up to you to define the configuration that you want, but your SAS Viya remains untouched on that. You can also disable the functionality. There are some rules in SAS Environment Manager that you can use to disable the export package functionality. So this is the end of the presentation. And as you can see, we have been able to build a simple web application which is still interactive, but based on static content that is extracted from the SAS Viya.